Be cleaning this place up right, thanks to you.
Excuse me.
Sometimes I think I like the fights more than he does. I think he just likes the father-daughter time. That little brain's under mine. He's a little devil. Sneaky as hell. I'm just gonna take your word for it.
The young people today are spoiled.
They've had everything handed to them.
Okay.
The skirt on that child. You know her parents didn't have to go out like that.
Huh?
Safe. And it's not just the mugging and the dope pushes. There's something.
I see we got ourselves a hell of a haul here. Cut that stupid nigga Emmanuel off at the pass.
Sweet baby Jesus.
Get out!
Ah! I'll kick your ass, you little shit! Ah!
We're cleaning this place up right, thanks to you.
Lukatu decided to stop by. Thought you forgot about me.
Running weed takes time.
That it does, frère.
Can't imagine what it must have been like running people. How many folks you think you got out of Haiti?
I only remember those I could not save.
Bullshit. When I was in country, once in a while we get a chance to evacuate a village before the napalm dropped. Wasn't a SOP, but we still did it. Had a couple close calls when the bombers showed up early. But I remember every single face.
So how many were there?
43. Should have been more, but some folks didn't trust us. Thought we were gonna march them into a shallow grave. Still remember the fear in their eyes.
Nothing motivates quite as well as fear.
Not a damn thing. So how would it? What was your count?
226.
Goddamn.
One boat every night for 10 months. Mostly women and children. The men were either enlisted or disappeared. We had more refugees than we knew what to do with. They didn't always survive the trip, but dying on the bateau running from Papa Doc was better than the alternative.
Dodging Dixie cocksucker sounds like Christmas morning by comparison.
If you would have told me 15 years ago that all this would happen, I would have called you crazy. I believe I'd die an old man with my family all around me.
Yeah. Not in this life, anyway.
No. Not in this life. Keep bringing in the marijuana, frère. This is our life now. Go to this warehouse. Inside, there's a large stash of our wheat. Kill the assholes gouging it and then bring it back.
You
wrong with you?
I said no grits, period. Can't stand it. Texas flat.
Honey, he's been catting around on her for the last
five. Oh, shit! Run!
Someone's in trouble.
Maybe stop over and see what's going on?
When they were growing up. But as long as he's happy, who gives a damn? No doubt.
All units, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols.
Up your dues in the next 2 days, we'll come collect them personally. And you don't want.
Ah!
them!
Truck drives by, driver has a life-changing moment, walks away. So that's where we step in.
promise. If you boys don't make this right, I'll take the entire union down with me. Is that clear enough?
Thank you.
look like a piece of shit. These good people. We all been. I gotta go meet this Cuban motherfucker, and I can't understand a thing he's saying. He's a goddamn...
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Pushing you.
I thought so.
They should have tore down that terrible amusement park years ago.
Any word about how it's going in there?
How you think? Beto's taking his beating. Wish Greco would just let us kill a poor son of a bitch. Get it over with.
Greco.
Thank you. some on me. That's probably what? Somebody's brains? A little bit of intestine, maybe? I didn't think Greco would... Jesus, God, I'm sorry. You gonna say something? Say something, goddammit!
Yeah, puke around
fuck
me
out
and
of me.
End up like
with
your buddy
Greco
there.
Around, ain't no one feeling real secure about that place, so we just keep at it.
You and me ain't getting paid enough to worry about
right. Me? Look, I get doing them coons over in Holler. Hell, bringing that dumb cracker Richie in makes some kind of sense, but Fido's me.
Looks like I got here just in time, Vito.
Lincoln. How's this possible? I thought you were dead.
Bullet was deflected by my skull. Came out the back.
Talk about some goddamn luck.
Worst place to shoot a fella is in the forehead. Skull's harder than you think. Come on. We need to have a talk.
When I heard about what happened, I went to Marcano asking my cut right then and there. I figured if he fucked you and Sammy, I'd be next.
I'm guessing he didn't go for it.
Said he wanted to wait for the heat to die down. Didn't want me running around, buying expensive shit, getting noticed. Like I'm some fucking amateur, never sat on a big score before. That money I fronted for the robbery was pretty much everything I put away. Didn't have enough to run, so... I stayed. Commission wouldn't let him just kill me, so I figure I'd make that cocksucker jump through every hoop, make him prove I deserve to get whacked. It wasn't much, but it was something.
Heard he brought in his nephew to push you out.
A kid named Michael Greco. Nephew by marriage, not blood.
Sure didn't number in here.
Yeah. They were looking to see what other rackets I was running. Like I'd leave a fucking paper trail in my office. Eh, don't bother with that shit. Look, appreciate you getting me out of the freezer and all, but, what are you doing here?
Marcano deserves to pay for what he did, so I'm going after him. Him, his brothers, his lieutenants, all of them. And I'm gonna need your help.
Look, pretty much whittled me down to nothing. I mean, this is it.
For now, maybe. Once I take back River Road from Greco, money will start coming in, it'll be a different story.
Also, we're partners now.
As long as you do what I say and give me what I want when I want.
So goodbye, Marcano, hello, Lincoln Clay.
It's either that or more of this. And next time, I won't be around to fish your ass out the freezer.
Nobody kills that scumbag but me. You bring me Greco, I'm in.
Tell me about his rackets.
He took over the dock union and he's got a warehouse. He has a lot of valuable shit in there. You take both of them out, Greco's finished. A couple of my guys been keeping tabs on him. You should talk to them. They'll fill you in.
All right.
Hey, Lincoln. I'm, still trying to get this place back in order.
I could use a little more territory. Look, just some room to grow, you know?
starts a revolution. So no kid of mine is gonna run off if his number comes up.
Preach. Vito says you're reliable.
Vito said you'd be expecting me.
Took you long enough. I'm Jock Blanchard. Vito claims you can unfug this mess and get us working men back on a job.
Maybe. Depends if your information's any good.
Used to kick up to Vito's men, Andy Toretto, for union work. But now that Coyon Greco got Andy squeezing everybody for more dues. You don't pay, you don't get a work permit. Poor fucks even gotta use Greco's loudmouth buddies to collect.
This Greco sounds like a real piece of shit.
You don't know the half of it. On top of that, Andy's gotta keep the permits under lock and key. Anything happens to those, oof. Ain't no work happening around here.
I'll see what I can get out of Toretto's people.
Toretto runs a tight ship, but you should be able to get some of his guys talking.
Let me put you in your place.
Next time you see that street preacher, tell me. He's been bargaining folks on that corner for days, and it's starting to scare off the customers. This city's going downhill, and fast.
I tell you about goddamn dealers. What?
Our boys into that grinder, and they keep throwing their boys in.
and nothing good's
coming.
Don't
fuck got himself
There's
killed.
There's something immoral about not using the bomb at this point. Everybody set!
Goddamn Dillas.
Trouble's coming!
Out of the way.
Hey, now.
What the?
Return to patrol. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrol.
Fuck this swamp cracker. Fuck it up for all of us.
All of us? You're the one trying to get at that hollow pussy. Damn, have your girl come see you?
Wait till I tell you. They find out. Shit!
We ain't alone.
Hey,
exactly ignore that.
What I can't understand is what kind of idiot makes his last stand at an old fun park.
From what I hear, Richie wasn't gonna be winning.
You boys heard that, right?
Smart. Anyways.
Yeah, anyway. What are we doing here, man? Sal pitching in with that Crocker motherfucker? Letting him lose a whole piece of the city?
Sal's up to something big. Looks like Richie, old Sammy, they was just little pieces in it. Whatever it is, it's way above what you and me get paid to know.
Cowboy up.
The hell?
Got a body here.
Oh, shit, that don't sound good.
Oh, you hear that?
The city ain't been worth a damn since Arlene hit. We got all kinds just streaming in from wherever. And it just don't feel like a place to raid your family anymore.
Wait, party can't be around here.
Negroes are behind
this. I have a wife, I have kids, please! Don't stick around, go!
That sound, what the hell was it? That was our target! That was our target! That was our target! That was our target!
copy. Stolen in River Row. If you could spare a moment, maybe stop and check things out. All units, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols.
Gotta get out of here! park in the hollow back when I was a girl. Always rode the Ferris wheel.
You sure you're on the wheels?
Stop them from hurting each other!
For fuck's sake!
Put your back into it. We don't got all day.
This is what happens when you lip off.
God damn!
Hell yeah! You motherfuckers need to wait for your turn.
Mon Jay, he killed him. Go, go, go!
Let's get out of here!
Is it raining again?
Is there a job as you've done slowing work at the dock union? I'm surprised Toretto's not out. Where it is, Andy Toretto's down at the dock union, demanding to know who's been stopping his people from collecting dues.
Think you tipped off Greco to what's been happening?
Nah. Knowing Andy, he'd probably see Greco in the ground next to you if he could. But he's a lifer. And if he's got a job to do, he's gonna goddamn well do it. Bad fucking situation all around.
And it's about to get worse. Tell the boys they'll be back to work soon, Jock.
You pissed Toretto off just enough that he's back at the dock union. You're gonna have to deal with him.
Thank you.
love the rain.
My back. Mr. Toretto sees you stoned again. He's gonna deal with you.
I'd like to see that fat old fuck try. I was hired by old pal Michael fucking Greco. I'm gonna touch
you. Buying the fucking work permits? What's the point of that? Can't we just print up some more?
Jesus Christ. Look, that's how it works. Those little slips of paper tell us who owes what. All that shit. Besides that, it's making us look weak.
To who?
Working men. They see us getting fucked. Won't be long before they think they can join in on the fucking. Anyhow, only thing you need to worry about is shooting that colored asshole if he decides to come back.
I heard he's with that pretty little Creole girl. Lola.
You want him brought back gentle or not so gentle?
Only mistake Bert made was fucking around after proposing to my little girl. Keep him pretty for the wedding.
I'll take a couple of guys.
No, you handle it. I need to keep enough muscle around in case that fucking nigga decides to show his face around here. Like I need Greco up my ass about one more thing.
Greco's on his last. You standing with him or me?
Fuck you. All right, I'm with you.
Vito will be happy to hear that. Dock union's under control. Put some of you guys on it.
You took those fucks out, huh? Good job, pal. I'll send some guys to keep watch. Get the warehouse, and we get Greco. Easy as your mama's fucking pie.
Today, I'm sure the file on Vito's skelet is about 3 feet thick, but that wasn't always the case. Hoover didn't even acknowledge the Mafia existed until 1957, so we weren't really keeping tabs on guys like Vittorio Scaletta till after that. Now, we know he served in World War II and did a 6-year stint in prison for theft and illegal distribution of federal rations. It's generally believed he was a made member of the Falcone family in Empire Bay, though he's also a suspect in the death of Don Carlo Falcone. Now, if he did kill the Don, Vito must have had friends in high places because he was allowed to live. He was exiled, though, and forced to relocate down here. And the commission convinced Sal Marcano to make Vito a lieutenant and give him some rackets.